Okay, yeah, let's talk about it. A few weeks ago, it sounded like Netflix and the BBC were going to ban the use of corsets in historic shows because of complaints from actors. It ended up not being true, with both Netflix and the BBC denying that they were banning corsets, but still, this is a great opportunity to talk about it. So corsets get a bad rap in film. We've all seen the clinging to the bedpost, sucking in, skipping meals, fainting. In reality, historically and otherwise, a well-fitting corset shouldn't hurt you or limit your breathing. If someone is in pain, actor or otherwise, it's not the fault of the corset. A corset should be anatomically informed, meaning it matches and hugs your curves and cinches you in tightly at your natural waist. Theatrical corsets made by costumers are often made to fit lots of people and so fit no one. And we know bodies come in all shapes and sizes. So of course a corset is going to hurt if it's a prop that's being used as a one-size-fits-all item, if you're not used to wearing one and suddenly you have to wear one for hours while filming, it's not anatomically informed for that person, or it's been specially made for someone else's body. At Dark Garden, as a business, we have made well-fitting corsets for both TV and film, including one very recent stunt corset we're not at liberty to discuss yet. It comes down to whether the production and costume departments have the budget and timeline to create or source corsets that fit properly. Of course, that's not always going to be possible, but still, the fault is not on the corset itself.